All right, let's talk about the new Rhino Assets tool by Environment for Revit and why it is so good for landscape architecture and outdoor design. Let's begin by entering the Rhino Assets console. This is a new project, so let's add a Rhino file. Here's gem number one. There is no need to even have Rhino installed on your computer. I actually received this file from our landscape architect, so thank you, Nechama. Gonna leave my parameters as they are and import. Now, let's look at gem number two. This interface allows me to control every single element I'm importing into my project. Here I have the layer, as it shows in Rhino, and underneath each layer, there are the objects that it includes. For example, now I'm looking at the topography. I can see here that this object is a berm, or a polysurface. If it had a name in Rhino, I would see it here. This fourth column let me assign a Revit category, or if I want, I can hit this three dots button at the end and have even more control. Here's gem number three. I can convert objects into system families, for example, toposolids. So now I can select any type that is loaded into my project. Notice that it doesn't work on every system family, but I hope this will upgrade in the future. Boom! Let's go through the same process with this paving layer. I can shift select multiple objects and click again on the three dots. I will select the category and type and hit OK. Now, check it out. It's a Revit toposolid. If I want, I can modify it like a normal topography. And of course, schedules and earthwork calculations. Same goes for the floors. I can edit them like I normally would. Okay, let's go back to the Rhino assets. Now, let's look at the walls and check out gem number four. Even though I'm not assigning a system family, I can still apply either the color that was assigned to that object in Rhino, or I can manually select a material. This time, let's select a material for the surface, and I will go for paving stones. And great! Let's do the same for the stairs. Shift select, pick a category, and assign the same material. Awesome! Now, gem number five. I'm going to select the trees as usual, but this time I'm going to import them as families. At the bottom of the window, I will select the Replace with Family option and select a family from the drop-down menu. Ta-da! Now it's a regular Revit family, and again, I can schedule, tag, and edit as usual. But that's not it. Let's look at this bench. I want to import it as a family, but I don't have one already existing in my project. That brings me to gem number 6. I can create a new family from my Rhino geometry. Let's call it Bench from Rhino. Select a category, assign a material, let's say natural stone, and hit OK. How amazing, huh? Again, for scheduling, etc. Let's do the same thing with this shader. Let's create a new family out of it. Welcome shader from Rhino, material, shader, very original, okay. Now, another gem, 7 was it? Is that I can hide undesirable elements. Let's just hide these curves that I'm assuming were part of the modeling process in Rhino and hit okay. There you have it, a Revit BIM model. If you're using Rhino and Revit, I highly recommend using this tool. Also, like and follow our channel. Ah, and join our webinar about Rhino to Revit. I will add the details in the description below. All right, bye.